Ever apologize to the acquitted Kenosha shooter Kyle Rittenhouse for suggesting online and on TV that he is a white supremacist?
Well, let's be clear what we're talking about here. This is about a campaign video released last year that used President Trump's own words during a debate as he refused to condemn white supremacists and militia groups. And President Trump, as we know from history, and as many of you covered, didn't just refuse to condemn militia groups on the debate stage, he actively encouraged them throughout his presidency. So, what we've seen are the tragic consequences of that. When people think it's okay to take the law into their own hands instead of allowing law enforcement to do its job. And the president believes in condemning hatred, division, and violence. That's exactly what was done in that video.
Jen Psaki, who gives me life.
Yep. Yes.
Okay, she went on to say.
You're saying that it was just a campaign video. It wasn't. The president also gave an interview where he said this Rittenhouse was part of a militia coming out of Illinois. Have you ever heard this president referring to Trump say one negative thing about white supremacists? These are all things. None of this was proven in the trial. And Kyle Rittenhouse is saying that the president had actual malice in defaming his character. Is that what happened here?
The president spoke to the verdict last week. He has obviously condemned the hatred and division and violence we've seen around the country by groups like the Proud Boys and groups that that individual has posed in photos with.
Yes, flashing a white power sign. Uh-huh. So there's that. Thank you, Jen Psaki.
Psaki.
There's Sean.
Psaki.
Oh my God. Uh-oh. Kyle Rittenhouse appeared on Tucker Carlson.
Yep.
Okay, as Jen Psaki just said, right, during the campaign, Biden tweeted about Trump disavowing, not disavowing white supremacists. Okay. Tucker asked, what did you make of the president calling you a white supremacist, which he didn't. It was, he was okay. Rittenhouse said, Mr. President, if I would say one thing to you, I would urge you to go back and watch the trial and understand the facts before you make a statement. Could you load the shut up cannon and just fire every okay. shut up in there? You murderous little douchebag.
I wish you could just shut your big yapper.
Shut up! Okay. Shut up! Shut up!
Okay.
Shut up!
Shut the f*** up, Donnie.
Okay. Yes,
oh,
both of
bitch,
you.
Police, take your line of bull down to the corner market and sell it there, because this five and dime isn't buying your line today.
Okay.
Shut up.
Okay.
Shut the hell up.
Okay.
Shut up. Shut up. Shut up. Shut up. Shut up.
Tucker Carlson asked Rittenhouse if he plans to hold some of these liars to account. And little douchebag said, I have really good lawyers who are taking care of that right now. So I'm hoping one day that'll be, and there will be some accountability for their actions and that they did. Oh, the president's scared, you murderous little douchebag.
Now he's going to cry that you called him a name. He's going to sue you. Steph's going to sue you.
BLM stepped on my tail.
Crier. He's a killer.
See? Okay.
That's a fact.
Okay.
He did
yes.
kill. He did kill.
He was in a, what do you call it? A picture with a white supremacist doing the white power salute with a free as t-shirt on.
And now he's going to cry about that too, Stephanie. You're going to make him cry again.
Oh, maybe he can fake it better.
Kyle Rittenhouse visited Trump at Mar-a-Lago. Trump revealed the visit during a Fox News interview with Sean Hannity. Hannity displayed a photo of the meeting. Trump said Rittenhouse had called and wanted to know if he could come over and say hello because he's a fan. Really nice young man, what he went through, prosecutorial misconduct. He should not have had to suffer through a trial like that. He's a really, really good young guy. He should, never should have been through that.
Okay. Can people like just call up Trump and say, hey, do you mind if I stop by? I'm a fan. How do you get his number?
Ugh. I can't. The amount of douchebaggery just in those two stories. Him demanding, what, an apology from Joe Biden? Or, oh, you should understand the facts.
Mm-hmm.
out, 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 out